Report readings. Signal getting stronger. Up ahead.
Is it Starfleet?
Yes, it's a Starfleet emergency code.
If it's them, how did they end up here?
I'll bet you a lot of Federation credits they had no choice.
Federation credits? Useless. Our payment of Latinum will do just fine. Let's go. Look at all these tracks. Someone beat us here. Unless we're talking survivors. Scan the interior.
No life readings. Massive damage to the ship.
Stay here.
Scanner indicates the ship was in a fierce battle.
Starfleet team is dead. One of them is missing. This is bad. Look, I've located the computer log. It was still intact.
Let's get back to the ship and contact the security division immediately.
Mr. Steele is waiting for our report. Team 2, this is Nelson from Team 1. Call off the search. We found what we're looking for. Report back to the ship now.
I was told to report to you on orders from Starfleet Security.
Come in. Sit down, please.
May I ask why?
No.
May I ask who you are?
I'll be the one asking the questions. However, you may call me Stobias. I'll be ready. The following interview is being conducted by Starfleet Security. You may request a representative. However, I have the authority to refuse that right.
Just what is this all about? Why am I being investigated?
Why indeed? Please state your name and rank.
Roberts, Susan. Science officer, currently assigned USS Aristarchus.
On stardate 6128.3, the Aristarchus' medical mission was interrupted by what is currently being referred to as an anomaly. We request clarification.
That event is all in my report. Why are you asking about something that happened 3 years ago?
I read your report, Mr. Roberts. Some feel it is lacking crucial details.
As a Starfleet officer, I don't leave out facts from my reports.
Unless you were ordered to.
Captain McNair would never make such an order.
Admirable, Mr. Roberts. It is always gratifying to see Starfleet officers defending their captains. However, let us stick to the point. I want you to use, in your own words, the actual events as they occurred. You may treat this request as an order.
We were transporting vital medical material, and were preparing to make our normal course correction in the Odin planetary system. As we came to our closest approach to Odin II, our ship was struck by an energy wave.
According to your report, you didn't know at the time it was an energy wave.
That's correct. The initial readings were confused. Later, the data was sorted out.
Describe what the computer reported.
The energy wave was created when Odin II was pulled into a vortex that engulfed it suddenly. As the planet vanished, it left a mini black hole in the space that it had occupied.
You realize that what you just described has been dismissed by our experts as unlikely. How do you explain this?
The data is available to Starfleet Command. The Aristarchus was pulled into a vortex that did not exist a moment before. I might not be able to describe it, but let me assure you, it was real.
And what do you make of this event? As a science officer, I cannot believe you did not want to study it further. I want to know what you really think, Mr. Roberts.
Odin II vanished. Cause unknown. Vortex created in its place. Cause unknown. If you're asking me to guess what it was, well, I don't guess. The only hypothesis I can come up with is a wandering singularity struck the planet, causing the fabric of space to become unstable, collapsing into a vortex.
But you have no evidence for a wandering singularity?
Like I said, it was just a hypothesis. Space is full of unknowns. Maybe if we encounter a similar event, we'll be in a better position to figure it out. It's all in my report. I left nothing out.
Except for this hypothesis of yours.
I don't speculate. I report the facts. I filed my theory with the science division after the completion of our mission. It's all on record, so I don't know why you're asking me this now.
Do you have anything further to add to your story?
No, and I stand by my reports.
Very well, Science Officer Roberts. This concludes the interview. You may leave.
If you tell me what this is about, I may be able to help.
The interview is over. You may leave. I do. She does not know what we do. But have our people keep an eye on her. We cannot afford to take any chances, especially now.
Consider it done.
Looks like you were correct. We will not find out anything new with this method. Contact our man and put our plan into motion while we still can. We will not go into this final darkness without a fight. And by all we believe in, we will seek out this new enemy and destroy them, or die trying.
clear to dock.
Ready for docking maneuver.
Lock on.
Systems locked.
Spaced out. You have control.
Affirmative, Hannibal. Enjoy the ride and welcome home.
Hannibal confirms. My friends, we've come home.
Acknowledged. Doors are closing.
Stand by umbilical and gravitational support systems.
Aye, sir. Moorings activated.
Continue docking procedure.
All systems standing by.
I want to thank you all for a mission well done. I want all of you to know it's been an honor serving with you. And it has been my privilege to lead the finest crew in Starfleet.
Incoming message for you, Mr. Sagan.
Sagan here.
Dan, you old space dog!
William Allen. How is life on Wellington?
Not bad. We're leaving orbit in 2 hours. And I wanted to congratulate you on your completion of the mission with the Hannibal. Any idea what you're doing next?
I'm off to attend the Vargas 6 Science Convention next week. Then I promised LaRocque I'd lend a hand with the results from our stellar scan we did last mission.
Sounds fun. But I wish you were going with us, my friend.
Why? What's up?
We're off to study those energy gates in 837-111. I wish I could tell you more, but I've already said too much.
Will, I know you. Something is up. What's wrong?
You've done a lot of favors for me. Hell, I practically owe my entire career to you.
That's an exaggeration.
Hardly. Keep your eyes open, Dan. I think something bad is happening, and I don't think they're telling us everything. I wanted to tell you, in case this mission failed.
Tell me what? You mean Starfleet is hiding something? I find that hard to believe. But if there's anything I can do, just name it.
Forget it. I'm acting like a first-year cadet. I'll try to contact you again when I get the chance.
You're being awfully mysterious.
I've gotta go get cleaned up. I gotta get back up to the Wellington. Dan, be safe. And watch your back.
You too, Will.
Take care. Alan out.
Now what the hell was that about?
At ease, Captain.
What can I do for you, Admiral?
Actually, Captain, the question is, what can we do for you? You've served Starfleet with honor and distinction for nearly 35 years.
I was only doing my job, sir.
And doing it well, Captain.
Thank you, sir.
Saying goodbye isn't easy, is it?
No, sir. It's not.
Have you given any thought to my offer, Elaine?
I have, sir. I'm not sure I'd enjoy being tied to a desk job. I don't enjoy paperwork as it is, sir.
As an admiral, believe me, you'll be doing a hell of a lot more. Starfleet needs good people like you. The next generation needs its heroes and teachers. So, will you come back home to us?
Space is my home. I don't know if I want to change that.
Change is inevitable. Our technology, uniforms, and our policies. Even your ship is being upgraded into the next class. You'll barely be able to recognize it when we're done. Everything changes, Captain. I think it's time for you to face a new challenge.
You'll have my answer in the morning.
I hope you'll be attending this evening's ceremony. A lot of Starfleet brass has shown up to congratulate you and your crew on the successful completion of your mission. Rest assured, the USS Hannibal has earned its place in history.
I'll be there, sir.
Very good, Captain. Think about my offer.
I will, sir. And thank you.
I'm sorry, Mr. Sagan, for the circumstances in which you find yourself, but you'll understand everything in a moment.
Kidnapping a Starfleet officer will land you in a great deal of trouble.
We are Starfleet, Mr. Sagan.
Who are you people? What's going on?
I understand that this is difficult for you, Mr. Sagan, and I have nothing but the ultimate respect for you. However, we find ourselves facing a situation so unsettling. Our very existence is on the line.
I've heard rumors that the Romulans and Klingons were forming an alliance, but...
Romulans and Klingons?
No, Mr. Sagan. Something far worse than that.
A new alien threat?
You do have good instincts, but let us waste no more time. Here are the ground rules.
I'm listening.
You will be told all that you need to know. Nothing more. If you decide to help us, further instructions will be provided. If you refuse us, then I'm afraid we'll have to wipe your mind clear of the last 24 hours, and you'll be reassigned to a remote outpost in the Garen 9 system. As a Starfleet officer, you are well aware that seemingly impossible things and situations happen routinely. Our universe never meets our expectations. It succeeds them every time. And so it is once again.
What has happened?
An unknown weapon has been used with devastating results several times.
I'm not aware of any recent attack.
That's because we've done our job.
The time is not yet right to disclose what I'm about to tell you. Evidence has come up to support the theory that the Earth was struck by what we thought was a very powerful scanning beam 517 years ago, originating from the future. There was a temporal signature that indicated where the beam would strike. On stardate 4833.3, it arrived as predicted. Just before it hit us, a temporal distortion formed and the beam went into the past rather than hit us in the present. We knew this would happen, although we could not stop it. For a fraction of a second, when the beam struck the planet, a vortex opened up and Earth fell into it. The vortex closed, taking Earth with it.
Assuming I believe any of this, if the Earth was sucked into the vortex, why is it still in its orbit as it should be?
Because the beam replicated us. Another Earth fell into the vortex.
How could you even know this?
I cannot tell you that, but the evidence is irrefutable. We now know where the other Earth is, thanks to a recent mission by the USS Enterprise.
You are talking about an event that alters everything that we know. What is this evidence discovered by the USS Enterprise?
The Enterprise was dispatched to look for the Exeter after it was reported missing on a mission to Omega 4. Captain Kirk discovered that the civilization there was identical with our Earth history to such a fine detail that the truth of it was not seen for what it really was, because of the impossibility of what it indicated. The facts are undeniable. Omega 4 was our replicated Earth, which had appeared into the Omega sector and continued with its existence independent of our own. Of course, Kirk and his crew could not have known this, but we knew what to look for. At the time of the beam's replication, recognizable parts of our civilization survived, but then diverged as the new history unfolded.
This is too much. It changes all we know.
And here is the strange part. Although our Earth was struck 517 years ago, it reappeared over 1,000 years ago in our timeline. Whether this was deliberate or a temporal anomaly, we cannot say.
You must show me this evidence. It will take several lifetimes of study to get this whole story told.
Mr. Sagan, while I appreciate your enthusiasm, do you really think you were brought here for some wondrous scientific mission?
I'm afraid you're not understanding the bigger picture yet. Regardless of the miracle of a replicated Earth, somebody attacked us. 3 years ago, the beam struck again. But Earth was not the target this time. The weapon struck Odin too, and created an energy vortex that sucked the planet into it, almost destroying the starship Aristarchus in the process. The planet was not replicated this time, and has not reappeared as far as we can tell. Right now, we believe it was destroyed by the vortex it fell into. We investigated, but found nothing useful. 1 week ago, our local energy gates leading to sector A37111 started disappearing. We sent the Wellington to investigate, but all contact with the ship has been lost. there was an increase of a residual energy signature that seemed to link it with our energy beam.
1 week ago? That's impossible. The Wellington left only hours ago for that mission.
I must apologize, Mr. Sagan, but you've been in stasis for a week. We needed to get you here and safely. You are far too clever, conscious, and we really needed to have this talk.
Stasis? Where am I?
Before you get angry and therefore distracted, let me give you the final piece of the problem. 3 months ago, we received a tip as to the possible origins of the weapon beam. A special Starfleet team was sent out to investigate, led by your friend, Thomas Roth. We had lost contact for a while, but Mr. Roth managed to get us some information. But the real message is hidden in a code we have been unable to break. We think you might be able to.
I'm a scientist, not a cryptographer. How am I supposed to believe your stories?
I am not here to convince you of anything. These are the facts. Incredible, yes, but verifiable nonetheless. We believe that the weapon will be used again, and whoever is responsible for it must be stopped. We are assembling a new team. We want you on it. You have a simple choice, Mr. Sagan. Either say yes or no. Yes will get you further answers, and no will earn you a painful memory wipe and a long trip home.
If Tom is in trouble, count me in.
Mr. Sagan, you do not disappoint. I would like you to meet Mr. Steele.
This will take years to sort out. But what I've gathered, I believe the evidence supports the events recorded.
It is important that you believe what we've told you is the truth.
But why do you need me at all? There has to be people who are qualified for these situations.
You are one of those qualified people. I hope you get that message through your head, because we have an important mission to accomplish. And I can't be holding your hand, explaining how wonderful you are when this whole thing gets underway.
Fine, I understand, Mr. Steele.
Have you translated your friend's message yet?
No, but Tom and I have worked together a long time. I'll figure it out.
Well, I suggest you figure it out as soon as possible. Thomas Roth holds the key to this whole mystery. We need to know what that is. Our lives could depend on it. Unless, of course, you're so smart you can do it while sitting there.
You look like a man in need of a shore leave. Well, my hard worker, give me the progress report. No, wait. Let me guess. You've made no progress at all.
Yeah, that's right.
Maybe I should kill you now. It's obvious how useless you are.
Oh, yeah? Make your move, Glorv.
If there's any killing to be done, it would be my decision. Now you two back off. You, progress report.
The machine seems to either ignore or fails to understand any attempts to program it. I don't know whether it's a language barrier or the original builder made sure it operated only for them.
My patience is almost at an end, Mott. I want you to prepare to fire the weapon again, using the previous random process.
Yes, yes!
My lord, if we do that, for all we know, the machine may turn on us. We simply cannot predict what it'll do when we activate the firing sequence.
Coward!
If we attract too much attention to ourselves, somebody's gonna find out where the attack came from, and then it'll be our turn.
You have 2 more days. After that, we deploy the weapon and use it. I want the Federation to understand how serious I am about destroying it. 2 days. After that, I will allow Glorpyr the pleasure of killing you.
Keywords I can work with. I need you to open a channel.
You do understand the concept of a secret mission? That means no transmissions, Mr. Sagan.
I need to verify something.
We're not on vacation here. What's the nature of this call?
I need the latest information on the Ilmar Nebula. And I happen to know that Science Officer Carlson is studying it, as we speak, at the USS Lexington.
I'm gonna assume that this is relevant to the mission.
The Ilmar Nebula is unique in many ways. I need to see what its dominant chemical signature is. If Carlson gives me the answer I need, then I may have a destination for us. I'm going to assume that you can get a message through to the Lexington for me.
Give me a minute.
You wanted to see me, sir?
A transmission was sent from this ship recently.
Do you know who sent it?
We're working on that. But you know what? I think we can all use this moment to learn something.
Yes.
Attention, loyal crew members. An unknown transmission was sent from this ship. And I've decided to take swift action. Somebody will die. I've decided to let God dictate who that will be. In 10 seconds, God will make his decision. And one of you will die. Very distasteful. Enjoy the show. If poor Hyder wasn't the guilty one, then I can assume we'll all be doing this again. Point made, yes? No transmissions leaves this ship without my orders. You!
Yes.
Progress report.
I'm working on deciphering the computer code to make it do what we want.
What I want!
Yes, of course. But it's slow going. There are lots of language barriers. Actually, that was Hyder's field of expertise.
Yes, yes. Well, now it's your field of expertise. If you want to live, you'll get my weapon working. Now get out! Everyone back to work!
Dan! Been a long time, my friend.
Yes, it has. I need a favor.
I owe you big time. What do you need?
I need the readings on the Ilmar Nebula. Specifically...
Careful, Mr. Sagan.
Whatever you have, Will.
Your time is pretty good, Dan. I was already sending a preliminary reading to the Vulcan Science Institute. I'll send you a copy as well.
Thanks. Here are the coordinates. And Will, this conversation never took place, okay?
You got it. If it was anyone else but you, you'll have the readings within the hour. Carson out.
We'll have an answer, sir.
The nebula is affecting our systems. It might delay our progress with the weapon.
You have courage, human. I'll grant you that. But we're not moving. Continue your work. Do you know what it's like to be so close to one's ambitions? Only to be told time and time again how it would not happen. The universe is a cold and hostile place. It's made me what I am today.
You know, Dysik, you don't have to continue with the course you're on.
I don't understand you, human. You join my crew, accept my conditions, and understand that I will kill anyone who doesn't follow my orders. Yet, you seem to be concerned for my welfare. That makes you the most dangerous man on the ship. Go away, human!
I will, if you answer one question.
Unbelievable! Ask your question!
Why are you doing this?
When I entered this galaxy through the energy gate, I found myself in two places at once. Where forever ends, I began. I was in the realm of Aznar, the god of all, and he came down and entered into me. I was to demonstrate his goodwill through dominance, and when all life recognized that life and death were his choices, and not some random chance, then his plan for us would be put into motion. I asked the god of all how I could accomplish his mission, and he said there would be a weapon for me to use. The very hand of God would be mine to use. When I awoke, my ship was all but destroyed. I drifted into this nebula, where the great weapon stood waiting for me. I was able to repair my ship, but the god's weapon remained a mystery to me. I needed help. Perhaps I wasn't worthy enough to operate the weapon by myself. So I left the nebula and recruited the best minds I could find. God deemed it fit to allow us to fire the weapon twice. But I wasn't pure enough yet. I can't control the weapon fully. God came to me and said that if I prayed hard and killed the weak, his mission could be accomplished. I don't want to kill, but I have to trust that God knows what he is doing. Surely you could see that I am doing right, that what I do is for the good of everyone?
I can see that you want to do the right thing.
Go back to work. Now, human! If you speak again, I will assume that you're weak. And I will kill you.
Any progress yet, Science Man?
No. I'm missing a piece of the puzzle. These readings are not adding up. I need to make one more call, and I'll need your help. Put me through to Advanced Starship Designs Division, Starfleet Command.
I'm burning through a lot of favors for you. Make this your last call.
What is going on?
The nebula storm shifting our position. If it gets much worse, we'll suffer serious damage.
We are not leaving the nebula. Devote more power to the shields!
But...
do as I say now!
We're patched in.
Dr. Dillard! Dr. Denton!
Dan, it's been too long.
I agree.
I'm in need of some information. I know the USS Einstein was cataloging some galactic anomalies near Base 237, using the cutting-edge sensors you guys helped develop. Can you tell me why that ship was recalled so quickly from its assignment?
We received word that the ship was damaged from pirates hiding in that area.
The sensors were targeted and almost destroyed. The Einstein managed to escape, though, and I do believe some pirates were killed during the battle.
I believe there is only one conclusion. The sensors were targeted to prevent the pirates from being discovered.
That was our feeling as well. Because of the current conflicts going on, Starfleet hasn't sent any other ships in the area since.
The fleet is spread pretty thin these days. A final question. Did the Einstein register 12.5 hydrogen atoms for every one helium atom during its scans?
That's remarkable. How did you know?
I can't tell you right now. I have to go.
You haven't returned my last two calls, Dan. Are you going to the Octorian Science Conference this year with me? Us?
I'd like to, believe me. Let me get back to you on that. If I can, I'll join you.
All right, Dan. Be careful. Hope to talk to you soon.
And if there's anything you need, Dan, well, take care.
I will. Thanks again. Sagan out.
Setting course 227.3 Mark 4.
Before we go chasing down the pirates, shouldn't we form an army or something?
It's all under control.
Great.
She likes you. You'd be a fool not to give it a shot.
Stay out of my private affairs.
You should go to that conference. That is, if we survive this mission.
I'm headed to the lab to finish my analysis.
You know what he's doing is wrong, don't you?
Shut up! Do you want us to get killed?
We're dead already. The moment he has this machine up and running, he'll have no more use for us. You know that, don't you?
Then what are you saying?
What do you know about the device he pulls out when he kills one of us? How does it work?
It's in us. Something in the food. Nanobombs that float around harmlessly until they receive a signal, then boom! The problem for Dysik is the bombs themselves. They don't stay in our system after a week, so he simply laces the food matter every 6 days.
When is the end of the next bomb cycle?
I'm not sure. 2 or 3 days from now. Doesn't matter anyway. Even if the bombs won't work, he'll just shoot us, or have Glorp do it.
I'm gonna see if I can access the medical scanner and adjust its settings to detect nanobombs. When the next cycle ends, we'll have to find a way to eat without ingesting any new ones.
And then what?
And then we take back our lives. I'm hoping that some friends of mine will come through. We've got to hang on until then.
I used to be like you. Hopeful, defiant, but I've seen too many friends killed. I just want to live as long as possible.
So do I, Valak.
Approaching planet Telef 2.
So explain to me why we're chasing after pirates again.
The pirates know everything that happened in this sector, Mr. Sagan, and I want to know what they know.
And you think they'll tell you?
Oh, they'll tell me.
And what do you want me to do? I don't think this is a wise course of action, Steele.
I really don't care what you think, Mr. Sagan. I'm in charge, and this is what we're doing.
I'm reading energy fluxes from the surface. It's possible the pirates are using some sort of energy dampening system or shielding. Any weapons we bring may be useless.
The kind I use.
thoughts, stranger. Leave while you still can.
I'm here to get some information, and you're gonna give it to me.
I think not.
Do you think you can stop me all by yourself?
And who says so?
This is going to be interesting. Okay, now it's your turn. You're gonna give me all the information I want.
I have nothing to say.
Really?
There are many ways to protect oneself. Observe!
This is your last chance, pirate. Look, this device, a little stolen technology from our Romulan friends, will settle the matter once and for all. The more you resist, the more pain you will feel. As each thought is extracted, the mind suffers damage, which cannot be undone. I am not without mercy. I can make your death quick and painless, or very agonizing indeed. I want answers to my questions, and I will have them now, one way or another. Pirate, I admire your resolve. If I were in your position, I'd do the same thing. It's unfortunate, but I have a job to do. Know that your death will probably save billions of lives.
lucky the ship had advanced medical equipment. You could have bled out.
I've suffered worse. The pirates work for an alien named Dysik, who pays them well to keep everybody away from this sector.
And now Tom's message makes sense as well. That transmission he sent contains the chemical breakdown of the Illumar Nebula. That's where they're hiding. So what do we do now? Call the fleet in?
I've informed my superiors. We're gonna stop Dysik.
Wait a minute. You mean to tell me the two of us will go in and stop this maniac and his powerful weapon all by ourselves? That's crazy.
Let me explain something to you about the nature of the universe, Mr. Sagan. It's not about logic or sense. It's about power and surprise. If a fleet arrives, the alien will see it coming and attack it with his weapon. But a little ship can sneak right in. Even if spotted, we won't be perceived as a threat. Remember, one man can destroy a world, another can save it. This is our job. This is what we do.
As a Starfleet officer, I'm trained to look at all options. Life should be spared if possible.
Let me tell you how it really is. While the universe is being explored and relationships established, the Federation leaves behind just as many enemies. We clean up the mess you fleet officers leave behind. While you sleep soundly in your beds, we lurk in the dark corners, doing whatever we can to preserve the freedoms you cherish so much. Life should be spared. If you only knew what the real cost was. People die, Mr. Sagan. Good people. To allow Starfleet to exist. Whenever possible, I kill them first.
That is the kind of barbaric thinking that holds us back from evolving.
Maybe. But we're buying humanity the time it needs to evolve. And it's all well and good to want to explore the universe. But you know what I've discovered? Everybody's the same. The strong survive and the weak die. You may not like me, Mr. Sagan, but you need me and others like me.
I refuse to believe that Starfleet sanctions what you do. They don't support murder.
It's all right, Mr. Sagan. You keep thinking that way. It's your strength. I respect that. Just know that there are people in Section 31 sacrificing everything to let you live that dream.
It is time.
But we're not ready. The machine...
You fool! Don't you know that I'm aware of all your activities? That you can talk to the machine and it understands you? Serve your purpose if you wish to live. Carry out my instructions now! Power up the weapon! Set it up for maximum destruction! Aim the beam through the 515 energy gate! Our target will be Earth! It is a blow that the Federation will never recover from!
Dysik, you don't want to do this. The Federation
is weak! God has revealed the weaknesses that must be eradicated! The Federation is the cause of all the problems in the galaxy. The sick are cured, the guilty are treated, an entire race that should have died are helped. They interfere in God's plan in all things!
How do you know that it's not in God's plan for me to tell you what you're doing is wrong?
Be quiet!
Stealth shields holding. No sign we've been detected. Heading for docking bay.
You certainly have some bag of tricks. Assume the alarm will sound once we finish docking.
I'll head for the bridge. You head for the weapons power center. Find a way to pull the plug. The shields are fully intact, but we can't beam in. Alright, we're flying it hard. Get ready.
Mm-hmm.
doors! Firing sequence activated. 3 minutes and counting. I'm locking the order in. God's will be done.
Congratulations, Dicey. You just murdered the food processor.
I will not block that! Ah! Time passed.
Are you a believer?
Why? Do you plan on saving me?
Your death will accomplish that.
Systems coming online.
Unbelievable. It's like watching a sleeping brain come to life.
Tom! All the answers are here. The appearance of the energy gates, the weapons beams, Earth, Odin 2, it's all here. This ship is the key. The species called the Death Bar use this vessel to suddenly invade, attack, and then leave this area before anyone knew what hit them. Here's the last log from the original commander. The constant travel through the gates mutated them, and they became a form of energy themselves. They're all gone. A victim of their own technology. I've just located the USS Wellington. the energy gates. If I can divert enough power long enough, I might be able to free her.
Dan, hit that panel. Third button on the left, then pull the lever.
Yes! The Wellington is free! The energy gate has collapsed, but she made it to Federation space! All the gates are going away. Systems are overloading. So many answers we're about to lose. If only... something. I don't know what it is. I can't stop it.
It's on power overload. It'll self-destruct in 7 minutes. Give or take.
Give or take? We have to get out of here. And find Steel.
Steel is here?
It's good to see you again, Tom.
You too, Dan.
Let's go! The ride is here!
You can't stop God. He'll always return. That's his power.
No. That's your delusion.
You're going to hell.
You first.
Get out of here, Mrs. Sagan. Go back to your precious Starfleet life. Mr. Sagan, if you're watching this, then I'm already dead. The ship has been programmed to take you back to Starfleet territory. For what it's worth, Mr. Sagan, working alongside you has made me realize that our work is not done in vain. If our sacrifices allow good people like you to do good in this universe, then I'm satisfied with that. Good luck to you. It's been an honor. Steel out.
Wow. I never expected that.
Sounds like you guys are a good team.
I guess so.
That explosion damaged your main engine, the leaking plasma. We need to find a place to make repairs.
Tale of Two is the closest plane.
Setting course.
But we have power. It's gonna be close.
I'm going to leave this ship for 1 minute and go out into our unknown alien planet. They have another thing coming. Not after what I've been through.
I think we're stranded.
Let's hope someone picks up on our distress signal.
Roth here.
Did you gentlemen enjoy your time off ship?
Captain Navarro?
Lieutenant, is everything all right down there?
Yeah, we're fine, Captain.
This is becoming a habit, gentlemen.
Yeah, unfortunately.
Lieutenant, what happened?
Our ship lost power, so we had to land on Tale of Two. I hope we didn't cause too much trouble.
Actually, I sent some shuttlecrafts out to search for you. One of the crews will pick you up, so stay in your area. I'm glad you're both safe and sound.
What are you doing out here, Captain?
Starfleet Command ordered me to take the Hannibal out of dry dock to find you. I have to thank you, gentlemen, for making my last mission as captain one of rescue. I don't like to lose any of my officers if I can help it.
Oh, thank you, Captain.
Yes, thank you.
I will expect a full report when you arrive, which will be in about 30 minutes. Navarro out.
Ever wonder what our future holds, Tom?
No, I like to live in the present. But I can say a vacation would be in order. That's reasonable for saving the Federation, wouldn't you say?
Yeah. I could use a break. But I have to make sure I get back in time for the Arcturian Conference. I am going to boldly go where I have not been before.
That's the general idea. It's never about the destination, always the ride, my friend.
Everything okay, Admiral?
Knock it off. Call me Elaine. I've been retired for over a week, remember? Yes, everything is fine. Can't help thinking what's going to be next. And if I can still make a difference.
I have to say, I really admire this new ship of yours.
One of the perks from a long career with Starfleet. She is impressive. I'm able to pretty much go wherever I want. I've been thinking of our old crew as of late. So many have gone on to be captains and officers. They did me proud. A great legacy indeed. It'll be good to see Commander Sonak again.
Sure will. I hear his son is doing quite well. Rumor has it he's up for promotion again. There's an opening on the Eagle from what I heard.
Fine ship. Would be a good match. Were we ever that young?
I can't remember. I'm too old. Distress signal. Wide broadcast.
Let's hear it.
Admiral Navarro, what luck! Blessed are the galaxy weavers!
Eltro, it's been a while. What can I do for you?
I intercepted a message from my base on Gamma Vox 4. The Avoxian rebel faction has declared war on the Federation and have surrounded the base from orbit. Nobody can get in or out. And they have scrambled all the subspace channels, so no messages are getting out now. I was just lucky to have intercepted their call for help when I did, before the blackout kicked in. And to think, I left on my supply run for the base just a couple of hours ago. The rebels must have moved in fast.
And as I recall, that base has no real defenses. How many people currently serving there?
1,648 Starfleet personnel and 112 native Avoxians. There was also a special diplomatic delegation from the Council that arrived a few days earlier.
What a mess. Who was leading that diplomatic delegation?
Dr. Jason H. Crandall from the Earth Council.
Dr. Crandall? Of course it would be. Can't say I blame the Avoxians.
Can you inform Starfleet, Admiral? The situation is growing worse, and the Avoxians are famous for their lack of patience. I've been monitoring their communications. Nothing further from our base, but the Avoxian rebels have announced their demands. Total surrender or full destruction in 3 hours.
That doesn't give us much time. All right, Eltro, stay out of the way. I'll inform Starfleet of our situation.
But 3 hours, how can...
Eltro, don't worry. I'm on it.
Very well, Admiral. If anyone can handle this, you can. Good luck.
Goodbye, Eltro. Get word out to Starfleet Command. Apprise them of our situation. In the meantime, set a course for Gamma Vox 4. I think it's time to see what this ship can really do. What do you think? Want to put the bullies back into their place?
Sure do. Remember you were saying something about making a difference a while back?
An ancestor of ours once said, "Destiny is not a matter of chance. It's a matter of choice. It is not a thing to be waited for. It is a thing to be achieved."
Couldn't agree more. Course change set.
You know, Derek, I'm only 75 years old. I'm still young enough to make a difference. Full speed ahead, if you please.
Aye, aye, sir.